Justine Louise, welcome to my channel. So this video is all about my November favorites. Now I was away for most of the month. I was in Australia visiting family, so I don't have a lot of beauty items to say talk about today because a lot of those new things arrived while I was gone from the Sephora sale, and the items I took to Australia were either favorites that I've already talked about that I use all the time, or they were things that were specific for that trip or travel size or things like that. So there was nothing really that exciting to mention. So I just thought I would do some of the travel items that I took with me that I absolutely loved. Now, one of the things was this Yeti. I got this because I had a recommendation from another YouTuber named Ms. Katie Hill. And I love drink bottles. I drink between 3 and 5 liters of water a day. So I travel with it all the time when I leave the house, and I like big, huge bottles. So I usually use Hydro Flask, which I love. I've been using them for years, and I mostly use them when I'm at the gym. It has to have a straw, and it has to keep my drinks cold for a long period of time, especially if I leave them in the car during the summer months, then it has to be nice and ice cold. So the biggest complaint I had from Hydro Flask is they don't fit in my cup holder. So it was rolling around in my car, and I just don't trust the lids, even though they say they're spill proof. I have had lots of accidents with those lids. So I was looking for something that had ticked all those boxes, and I found my Yeti. So I ordered this directly from the Yeti website. They do have them on Amazon, but they didn't have the pink. It has a really neat lid. I actually ordered this one separate. It normally just comes with a regular lid, but I love the straw. And it has a little stopper on it so it won't fall out. And I've taken it out with me a million times, and I have tons of ice still left in my drink, and I'm so happy. I don't know if I would trust it 100% for spillage, but as long as it fits in my cup holder, I'm not too concerned. I just don't like drinks rolling around, and I wouldn't put this in a purse or anything like that, but I'm very happy with my Yeti. So the next thing I'm going to talk about is from Barefoot Dreams. I did mention this in one of my fashion haul things. If you've never tried Barefoot Dreams or touched them, you've got to. It's like, I think it's chenille. That would probably be my best description of the fabric. It's lovely, cozy, and warm. Now, I ordered this from the Nordstrom Anniversary Sale, and there were a lot of neat cardigans and things as well, but I decided to go with this one. So this is tucked inside the pocket, and it's to make a pillow. This is actually specific for traveling. So I liked it because it makes a little pillow, and I stored it in my carry-on bag like this, so it's nice and compact. Then when you unravel it, it turns into a beautiful shawl with pockets. Now, I've used this around town just wearing it as a shawl, but I will be honest, I don't really like having my arms confined inside. I'd rather have a poncho or something with sleeves. But on the plane, this was lovely and so cozy and warm, and I used it just around my shoulders, and I also used it as a blanket because it's a nice long full length like that. I also used it, believe it or not, I wore it to watch my brother play hockey. Yes, in Australia, I watched him play hockey. So I only came to hockey to Australia with shorts and tank tops and flip-flops. My brother said, it's gonna be freezing. So luckily I had this nice shawl, and I wore this in the ice cold arena, and I was toasty and warm. So I highly, highly recommend this. Anything from Barefoot Dreams. I'm actually eyeing up a couple of the cardigans for possible Christmas gift for myself, or maybe for other people, we'll see. Now the next item is from Longchamp. It is the shopper, La Pliage. I'll put the link below. I actually bought this one used because I just wanted to try it out. I normally travel with my Coach leather tote, but it doesn't have a closure, it just has a little magnetic clasp. And when it's going through the security, the camera thing, it tips over, and I always think some of my things gonna fall out. And also when it's under the seat and it's dark and it's so cramped, I don't know if things have fallen out. So this actually has a zip close, which appealed to me. And everyone's talking about these shoppers. They're not particularly attractive. I'm a big purse junkie and bag junkie, so it has to look good. So this one, I was like, I'll try and see what all the fuss is about. So again, I bought it used just to see if I liked it. Wasn't crazy about red, but again, it was a used price, and so I couldn't really be fussy. So what I like about it is it packs up nice and compact, so you could put this in your carry-on, or you can put it in your suitcase and use it for when you arrive at your destination if you want a shopping bag, or you can use it when you're on your way home if you've bought some items and want to use it as a bag to come home with. So it's nice and small, nice and light, and it also opens up like that into a nice full tote and nice big bottom. It fit so much stuff. I love this bag. Absolutely loved it. I used it in Australia as a shopping bag, so I only brought a small little clutch with me, a small shoulder bag, and I put that in here, and then I put my water, a raincoat, an umbrella, yes it rained when I was there, a cardigan, hat, any little extra piece, some snacks, and then they were all inside this nice big tote. And then I had it when I was shopping, if I made any purchases and just wanted to put them all in one bag. So there you can see there, it's a nice big bag and zips closed, so you don't have to worry about security. And again, going through airline security, so nothing will fall out. Very nice, high quality bag, well made. But the thing I liked about it the most is we were actually caught in a torrential rainstorm. Luckily I had packed my little Lululemon packable raincoat with me, but it didn't protect all the things I bought. I threw them all in this bag, and it was like a plastic bag. No water penetrated through. We were all drenched. Nothing penetrated through this bag. It was bone dry on the inside, so it's obviously treated with something, and you could just wipe it out if you used it maybe as a diaper bag. If you have any spills, it's just literally rubber plastic inside, and outside was dry as well. Amazing. I highly recommend this bag. So much so that I'm going to sell this one, or possibly give it to somebody, and I ordered the black. I'm a very matchy-matchy person, and this kind of bugged me when I was away. If I was wearing something like this and then a red bag, I just don't like it. I just have a thing with being matchy. So I've ordered the black, and that way I'm safe. It'll go with everything because I'm going on a trip to South Africa in February, and I definitely plan to take that as my carry-on bag. It's black, so it'll go with everything, including my nice Barefoot Dream shawl. And it will be nice when I'm in the game reserve because it's very dusty and dirty, and then it'll be just wipe it down. I don't have to worry about it. With my leather bag, I was always a bit concerned it would get wrecked. So very happy with this bag. As I mentioned, I bought mine used, but you can order them pretty much everywhere. I ordered mine from Costco, the black one, so I'm very excited about that. So I have another favorite. This one is a beauty. I mentioned that I got this, I think last month. It was a little point, not a point perk, but when you buy from Sephora online, you can get a little deluxe size of something if you spend $25. So this was in there. It's Grand Mascara. I've never really heard of this brand, but I actually love this. I took this to Australia because it's nice and small. I didn't have any raccoon eyes, no transfer above or underneath. It gave me nice thick lashes that I was very happy with. So far it ticks all the boxes. I know I did buy the Sephora Lash Stash from the Sephora VIB sale, so I've got lots of samples to go through, but so far this has been my favorite, so I think I'm going to be repurchasing this one for sure. So lastly, I have a couple fails. One of them is Marc Jacobs. I've heard so much about Marc Jacobs products, none of them, I can be honest, have really wowed me. I've tried quite a few things, lipsticks and glosses and this and that, eyeliners, so I thought I would try the foundation because it was on sale. I think it was a weekly wow at Sephora or something, but it was half price, and it's the Genius Gel. I'm not wowed by it. There's nothing fabulous about it. I'm wearing it today. It's okay. Anyway, I got it at a discount, so I'm not too upset about it, but it's okay. I definitely wouldn't recommend it, even at the discount. I don't think it's worth it. So anyway, that was that. And the last thing is these little shoes. I mentioned them in my travel video that I had just bought them and I was going to pack them. They're nice and light, small. They come with this little bag that you can just slip in your tote. And if you have high heels on, you can switch to them if your feet get sore. I've seen the same kind of thing for ladies going to nightclubs and they switch to ballet flats. However, I had these little booties on. I wore them. They're Toms, very comfortable. But I was shopping, I was in Vancouver running around, my feet got sore. I put these on and my feet were more sore. So I will never wear them again. So these are going to be donated. I won't wear these ever again. And I wouldn't recommend them. They're not great. And they're a little bit on the bulkier side, but they're nice and light. But anyway, they're not comfortable. Don't waste your time. And I actually have one more favorite that's on the same line as shoes that I forgot to mention because I had them on the floor. Is these slip-ons. I mentioned I bought these in one of my shopping hauls. I wasn't sure if I wanted to keep them. They're a little outside the box for me as far as style. I love them. I wore these on the plane. They were magnificent. Walking through airports, they're slip-on, slip-off when you're going through security and they want to take your shoes off. They were amazing, so comfortable. They went with everything. I could wear them with shorts. I wore them with a Lululemon outfit that I wore on the plane. Just so comfortable, so nice that I've now bought them in the beige. But I did buy them at the Black Friday. They're actually on sale right now at Nordstrom. So I bought the creamy beige color and I'm so excited to get those. I'm going to put them under the tree so I'm not going to be that greedy. Anyway, I love these runners. Fabulous. Highly recommend them. So that concludes my November favorites. December favorites, I will promise you will be a lot more beauty related because I'm home now and I got all my deliveries of Sephora and all different things and I've done some Black Friday shopping, so I'm sure there's gonna be lots of goodies in there that are gonna be favorites for this next month. So anyways, I hope you liked the video. If you did, please hit like and subscribe. I have lots of content to post, lots of exciting things, some holiday gift ideas that are coming up, so please stay tuned and thanks again for watching. Bye.